Hello friends, here in this video we will see the stress strain graph for ductile materials, and for that purpose I have drawn the diagram. Here in this diagram we have on y-axis stress and on x-axis we have strain. So this video will show us stress strain graph for ductile materials. Now as I have drawn this graph, here we can see some lines which I have drawn in red. This is the origin O. Now when we look from in this graph, there are various points from O to A. As we can see here, we have an inclined line, and this is, we can say that since it is an inclined line, it is not a curve. So here we are getting a linear relationship between stress and strain, and I can say that here O to A, it is called as proportional limit. Now when we say that from O to A it is proportional limit, it means if we go on increasing stress, strain will also increase, means the relation is directly proportional. So in proportional limit I can say that therefore stress is directly proportional to strain. So now as we can see in this stress, I've denoted it by sigma, strain it is denoted by letter E. If I remove this proportionality sign, I have a constant here called as capital E. I'll say that where capital E, it is called as Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity. Its unit is Newton per mm square. So as we have seen in this graph, from 0 to A it is proportional limit. Now when we reach point A, that is if we are increasing the stress and we reach up to point A, then we are getting a strain value as well. Here there will be stress and here we are getting strain. Now the moment we remove the load from point A, it means stress becomes zero. So if I remove the load, this object will return back to its original shape. It means it behaves in an elastic manner. So within this 0 to A region, the material behaves in an elastic manner. That is, when the load is removed, it will regain its original shape. Next, we see point A to B. That is, I'll write it down here on the next page. From A to B, it is called as elastic limit. Now, when I talk about elastic limit, from A to B, again as we can see here, that when we have reached point B, from A to B it is a curve. Now, from 0 to A, the relation between stress and strain was linear. From A to B, the relation is, it is a curve. So the relation is not linear like it was from 0 to A. But even at point B, if we are removing the load, the material will regain its original shape. So from A to B, it is elastic limit. Now, when we go from point B to C, the change in stress is not very much. As we can see, there is very little difference between B to C. So I can say that B to C, it is called as, here I'll say that point C is called upper yield point. Is called as upper yield point. It means at point C, the yielding has started. Yielding means change in shape. So once the material crosses point B, it reaches in the region between B to C where it will be permanently deformed. That is, if we remove the load from point C, then the material won't regain its original shape. It means at point C, it has deformed permanently. So this B to C region, it is also called as permanent set. Now, when we are from region C to D, as we can see in this diagram, now compared to point C, point D is below. It means the stress at point D, it is less compared to point C, but the material is deforming more. As we can see, at point C the strain is less. Strain means the physical deformation, and at point D the strain is more but stress value is less. So here I can say that C to D, point D is called lower yield point, and strain is more at point D than point C. Next, as we can see in this diagram, D to E, here again stress is increasing in a tremendously high manner. As we can see here, we can look at the diagram. The stress at point E, it is the highest point in this graph. So here we are getting maximum stress. So I'll say that point from the region D to E, here point E is called yield point, and stress is maximum at the yield point. Now, up to point E the stress is maximum. Then if we go from E to F, the stress will go on reducing. As we can see, the graph is falling. So here stress decreases, and from E to F we can say that stress decreases but strain increases, as it is very much clear from the diagram. From E to F the stress is falling whereas the strain is increasing. Here we can look at this, and finally at point F, here I have marked star, the material will be breaking, and this is called as breaking point. So I'll say that at point F the material breaks, hence it is called as breaking point. So now it is very much clear from this stress strain diagram that this is for ductile material, and ductile material will be flowing like this. That is, it shows the strain variation, and strain is nothing but physical deformation, which we can see, and we can see the material flowing, and finally it will break, and this breaking point is just after the material has reached maximum stress. So we can say that if the material is having maximum stress, after that it can break at any given point. So in this video we have seen stress strain graph for ductile materials.